We are in a global water crisis. Around the world, 2.2 billion people lack access to safe water. But what if the solution was all around us? Within our atmosphere exists more than six times the water than all the planet's rivers combined. And now, thanks to one ingenious solution, we can capture water from thin air and deliver it to communities worldwide.
My name is David Hertz, and my innovation XPRIZE winning technology is called the WEDEW, and the company is called SkySource.
SkySource's innovation won the Water Abundance XPRIZE after meeting guidelines to use renewable energy to harvest 2,000 gallons of water from the air for less than 2 cents per liter.
Being a Southern California native, we have a very tenuous relationship with water, and that led me to atmospheric water generation and SkySource.
The SkySource team used temperature differences to cause atmospheric water to condense. Now, to create heat, you need energy. And Hertz and his team found a clever way to use a renewable energy source to make their process even more effective.
My innovation was pairing atmospheric water generation with biomass gasification that has a huge energy density, about 10x that of solar. It's a non-intermittent renewable source, and it uses one of the most abundant fuel sources, which is biomass.
Not only does biomass create electricity, it also creates heat. SkySource's innovation found a way to leverage this otherwise wasted byproduct.
Not only did I have energy in abundance, but I had heat in abundance, and I was able to use that heat to extract the moisture that was still left in the biomass and create a superheated absolute humidity atmosphere, kind of an augmented atmosphere, that then allowed me, even without electricity, to condense that against a cooler ambient temperature.
Now, creating water from the air may sound impossible, but David proved that this technology could work. In fact, it worked so well, it outstripped the prize guidelines.
We ended up generating over 2,200 liters in 24 hours, and we did so at not 2 cents, but a quarter of a cent. It still feels like a miracle that you're making water from air.
The Water Abundance XPRIZE helped SkySource find their solution, challenged them to meet deadlines, and showed the world that innovation can truly come from anywhere.
You're having to meet, again, really objective criteria, not subjective interpretations of things, but, you know, very scientific goals that are measurable and actionable. Much of what the XPRIZE does is to kind of encourage these emergent technologies. And so to have a benchmark of where you are in the world of other technologies, you really get the best of understanding what the field is and best practices are within that industry.
Impressively, SkySource was not originally in the competition finals. They were only invited after it had already begun, putting them behind every other competing team.
The only way to compete to raise money was to pull out a mortgage on my house. It's a hell of a good incentive, besides the desire to win an XPRIZE and to address, you know, a humanitarian crisis. But they also gave us personal motivation, and thankfully we won.
Since winning, SkySource has partnered with the UN's World Food Programme to address water scarcity in Uganda, Liberia, and India. And their work isn't done yet.
We're gonna need nimble systems, a different approach to the way that we've addressed the problems in the past, which are generally large, slow-moving, central infrastructural systems versus fast-moving, nimble, flexible, highly replicable systems.
World-changing solutions can come from anyone, anywhere. All it takes is bold action and a great idea.
I think if people are afraid to take risk and fail, then they've kind of already failed. You don't have to win. You're still winning by just competing and innovating. You might meet somebody, you might discover something about yourself, about your field, that could lead to something, and it's always better than doing nothing and being ambivalent about it.
To learn more or join a team, visit xprize.org.